I was getting into fights, getting in trouble in school, and my
out of randomness, like I would hit myself when I would get mad.
Because
like,
every penny I got, I wasted it on drugs.
High school, and I started sneaking around and partying. And
I pretty much hated everybody that was around me.
Like I just thought everybody was out to get me, and that's just how it was.
She ended up getting in my face, and I ended up like headbutting her. That was the first time I ever got physical with my mom.
Actually, I was so out of control. My mom had to call the police on me twice.
Every parent eventually discovers that raising a teenager is a challenge. For some, the situation becomes so out of control that it feels like all hope is lost.
Our attempt was to remind her of past memories and anything we could do to try to touch her heart. And it didn't work.
It's so sad when a parent comes here because they're mostly in tears. They say, this is our last hope. If you can't help our teenager, then we don't know what we're going to do because we've tried everything else.
Across the United States, Houses of Hope provide a residential home, a Christ-centered refuge from a life of degradation and exploitation.
We get them rebellious, they're sexually abused, they've been on drugs, alcohol, prostitution. They never find the satisfaction they have, that they find when they come here and find Jesus Christ.
I think it was my second week here I was saved, and was like, you know, I don't know what I'm doing, but I asked the Lord and he came into my life, and then he just started talking to me a little bit.
Once he got in here, things just start happening, things just start changing, you know, God just started working on him. And I think he got out of the way of himself to let God be able to come into his life.
So that false nose would not block their passage. I was never the type of person to apologize, and this program has helped me to learn and taught me basically how to humble myself and apologize for my wrongdoings.
You know, they're really searching, trying to find their identity. They're trying to find out who they are. And that's the neat thing about House of Hope. We help them find their identity so they can fulfill their destiny.
House of Hope provides a loving, stable family environment in which residents are expected to accept responsibility, submit to authority, learn their boundaries, and develop healthy relationships with peers and adults.
You show your bad side, they still show their good side, and they still open their arms, you know, because they still love you no matter what.
Sometimes you're just having the worst day, and you're just like, oh, I just don't want anybody to talk to me, and I just want to curl up in a ball and cry. And then they always get it out of you. Like, they're just good like that. They always get it out of you.
So she just showed me that, you know, my parents really do love me and that they don't just want the worst for me, they don't hate me and all this stuff, and I always thought they hated me.
Expectations do not stop with the teenager. House of Hope understands that healing involves the whole family.
I did not realize what it was going to require of Dad, and I thought that she was the one who needed to do most of the work, and it turns out Mom and Dad had some improvement to do also.
At first, the parents think it's the child's fault because their teenager's on drugs or alcohol or having sex or cutting themselves. We know that the fruit doesn't fall far from the tree, and we know that these teenagers didn't get this way by themselves.
Parents are required to attend their own individualized counseling, counseling with their child, a weekly parenting class, and a support group with other parents.
It wasn't just her, it was me. And I had a lot of issues by myself that I didn't know. So as soon as I started changing myself, she started changing herself.
It's like a comfort. We help each other. And not only helping, but we have a teacher to teach us things, and we can implement this stuff to our other kids at home.
We can't take care of your teenagers. That's not our program. We can take care of the family and reconcile it and restore it and bring healing and wholeness.
It feels great that I can just restart and just turn my life around.
To look at myself, what I used to be and what I used to do and how I used to treat my family, it really does kind of disgust me. Drugs took it away, but House of Hope and God giving it back to me.
That's what our whole job is to get in there and turn things around and get them saved and healed and delivered and set free so they can be that man or woman of God that they've been called to be.
Is she a perfect 18-year-old? No. Am I a perfect mom? Absolutely not. But we're working on it together.
Without House of Hope, Kiwanis would be in the streets. Kiwanis would be probably selling her body. I don't know where Kiwanis would be if it wasn't a House of Hope.
The future of our country is in dire straits if we don't get these teenagers and do something to them and help them develop their character.
As a faith ministry, National House of Hope operates independent of government support, relying solely on the generosity of caring individuals. Your financial contribution allows National House of Hope to continue restoring families and giving teenagers a second chance at a bright future.
I was, you know, on the path of destruction, and now I'm seeking after God. It makes my heart overflow. It makes me really happy.